Welcome to the Doom Collectibles Guide. Use the annotations on screen or in the description below to choose a level you're having trouble with. Alright, first long level. So, right here in Argent Facility. Right as you begin, you've got two of them right off the bat. Now, one of them is a data pad, which we're going to go for first, but at the same time, right afterwards, I'm going to be doing this rune and getting that out of the way. Now, you'll see that in another video, but yeah, here's the rune right here, and you can see it on the map where I'm at. This is, well, actually a little bit further away from the beginning than I thought. So yeah, just go up, touch that, clear that rune. Now come over here and go up this set of stairs. There will be enemies here. I do have to say that. But, data pad, right here. Now, I'm going to go take care of this rune real quick. Oh, wait. First things first, achievement pop. Now, this is the achievement for collecting all 100% of the data pads. If I'm thinking correctly, data pads, artifacts. If I'm thinking correctly, this is all of them. This is actually all of them for me, because with some of these achievements, they go roundabout to where if you collect them all in separate playthroughs, then you've got them. So there's that achievement. I just wanted to show you guys, I guess. Why I'm taking so long, I have no idea. As far as moving on to the next one. There we go. Alright, so from this data pad, I just cleared the rune, actually. There we go. There's the rune, and there's the data pad where I'm at. So what you want to do is you want to come over here behind these barrels and find a lever. Once you get that a good pull, there we go. Alright, now, follow my lead. Now, this is continuing on with the level, so there will be enemies here, I think. So, yeah, clear them out and come in here for Doom Map from Doom 1, Toxin Refinery. Now, all I'm doing here is just checking for extra secrets, which I could have just looked at the map because that actually shows the depth and width of this map in its entirety. Plus, I don't have the blue key card yet, so can't get in there, even if there was something behind there. And I don't want to jump down without the high jump boots. Otherwise, never mind, I did. Whoops. But yeah, that is acid. Oh yeah. But yeah, there's Toxin Refinery. Okay, next up is the field drone. Now, there is a glitch to where you can get it beforehand, and I am going to actually attempt it. I will put it in the description below where I actually glitched it out. I don't know if they've patched it, though, because I haven't been on in a while. A couple of days at most. So I don't know if they patched it yet, but here is the exact location of where it's at. All you have to do is follow my path and then wait for it to get there. Once it's there, it's yours. And that's the path I took. And then once it's there, the field drone is yours. Alright, next up is two elite guards. Now, first one is right around where I'm at here. I don't remember exactly where this is, but yeah. I mean, you guys can see it on the map, so here we go. Alright, now. Yeah, okay, so it's on a little bit of a ledge, so you're gonna have to jump up to it. It will be on your left as you're going through the mission, now that I'm actually remembering where I went. Now, this next one is right over here where you first spot the field drone before you go after him. You need to go down there. That way. Yeah. Jump. Collect the munitions box if you need it. If not, just jump all the way down. That's the fastest way to go. Otherwise, you can go around. Now, there will be enemies spawning in up here. I think it's just a couple of imps. So, take care of those guys and get... Oop. Huh, I didn't realize how many there were. But you can collect that, collect your armor, and... Creator token. Thank you, elite guards. Alright, next up is... I believe this is the first filter that you have to destroy. As you can see, this is where it's at. It's either the first or second filter. But this is just for a data pad. So what you want to do is you want to come back this way. And boop, right there. Alright, next up is Argent Energy Cell. Now this is the site of, I think, the first or second gore nest. So what you want to do is you want to come over this way. Pop into here. And now there will be enemies spawning in. I did not realize that, which is why you're seeing me fight them. Now, I'm going to fight them for a few seconds, but where I just was is where you need to go. Right through here. There we go. Now, take note of where you are, because in the next part of this, I am actually going to be showing you... Oh, where is it? Another rune, I think. Yes, another rune. Okay, so let me take care of these guys real quick. I think that's all of them. Alright, so for this one, like I said, the Argent Energy is right there, but I am actually above the floor. Now, the best thing for this, like I said, is going for a rune. Let me get out of the map here. There we go. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to jump onto there and then jump up here and then make your way through here. Boop. Boop. Now this is also where that filter was. Now there is a way to go this way, but I'm going to show you guys this way. Now I believe that is the second filter, but I'm not entirely sure. So anyways, pop through here, up here, have to do a little bit of platforming, and there's your room. Alright, and next up is a data pad. So from this gore nest here, what you want to do is you want to come over here. Yeah, man, look back at the box. There we go. Jump up on the box, and then jump up onto this platform here, and then go through here. Now, one thing is this is supposed to be the data pad and a field drone, but I kind of messed up because the field drone is supposed to be right there. But instead, here's the data pad. Now, all I was trying to do was come through here and actually grab everything, but there's the field drone up in the air somehow. So it pretty much means I gotta clear everybody out before the field drone actually comes down and says, hey, look at me. So, yeah. So pretty much I'm looking all over the place, not knowing where the heck it is. And then, lo and behold, all I gotta do is just clear everybody out. And there he is. Yep. Alright, next up from the same gore nest, this is another triple threat one. First up is an elite soldier, then a collectible, then a secret area. Now, we've got two paths to take. First path, that's the second path. Turn around, there we go. All right, so first path, go along this platform here. And then just turn to your left. Boom. Leak guard. Next, backtrack. You can even climb over this just to get a little bit faster, but not much. And then just follow this path. Now you want to make a right here for the collectible. Follow the way I go, walk along these air ducts. And then you can jump in through either of these two windows. I chose to jump in through the first, but then you get your collectible, Stealth Guy. Then you can either choose to jump down or go back the way you came and then walk along the ground. Either way, follow my path. There will be enemies here, I think. Yes, as you can see. Go through here. And then there will be enemies here as well. Along with... Get it? There we go. Super shotgun. Come on. There we go. Pick it up. Now, funny thing about the super shotgun, every time you pick it up off of a dead body, it will have blood on it. Every level afterwards, no blood. But therein lies the super shotgun. And just how awesome it is. Alright, next up is the auto map. Now, getting it this late in the game doesn't really help much, but here's where it's at. As you can see where I am on the map, yeah, this is where we need to go. Now this is a secret area, there's the gore nest over there, and now you can see I'm on the opposite side of the gore nest, and I had actually already opened the door. Now, let me get to the door. It already opened the door, but I didn't activate the secret because, boop, there we go. I have to actually go through the door. Now, this is a secret area along with the auto map. So, take the auto map for your liking. And then kill everybody that comes your way. Simple. Alright, next up is a data pad. Now, I forget exactly where this is, so just bear with me. There we go. Ah, yes, it's probably the third filter if I'm thinking correctly. So take the data pad and munitions box on your left. There we go. Only needed a little bit of ammo, really? Wow. Okay, next up is the last collectible of this level. Now as you can see, I'm right next to a rune trial. Now this is earlier in the game. I actually missed this one, but if you go down through here from the rune, jump up on top of these boxes, and then up on top of the filter here, come on, get up there, there we go. Now this little walkway leads you to UAC guy. Alright, and the last little bit, the elite guard. Now, this is where you need to go after you've taken out every single filter. Now, as you can see, most of the map has been blued in, but not all of it. Now, normally you would go that way, so this is a missable object. Or, this is a missable elite guard, but instead, turn around and get your token. Alright, Argent Energy Tower, here we go. First up, we got another triple. Actually, I think this is our first triple. But anyways, right off the bat, you can grab your jump boots. Now, this is actually pretty decent. These things are actually pretty decent. We're going backtracking. Now, to the left of the jump boots is your very first data pad of the level. And then, if you follow me, I'm just going around collecting ammo right now. but follow my lead to an Argent Energy upgrade. Now, you're going to be doing some platforming here, and I actually forgot that I needed to be turned around for this. So, jump. There we go. Now, this is also me just testing out the jump boots as well. So don't mind me double jumping out of joy. But anyways, go in here, and you don't need a couch because you get full standing leg room and an energy cell. Alright, now let me just choose this, then we can continue on our way. Now, you're going to backtrack a bit. And down, there we go. And that's where you want to go, but I'm being an idiot, so I'm going to go this way. Now, yes, I am testing out as well. Now, I'm trying to get in through this upper window above the door, not even realizing that there's glass there. And then, boom, there we go. Okay, now I know where to go. So jump up to here and fall down. Collect all the armor and ammo in here. Ammo? Ammo! Yay, ammo! So collect all the armor and ammo in here, along with the next room. Now, next up is a field drone. Now, what you want to do is come up here, all the way up to these two towers. This is where you'll see the Hell Knight on the bridge. So, yeah. Now, if I'm thinking right, these are air control towers, but I'm not entirely sure. But anyways, this is for a field drone. Now, there's a data pad right over here that I did not even see. So, go back here, grab the field drone. Now, I will be back to grab the data pad in just a second, but first things first, there is a not-so-secret secret, which means it does not count as a secret, but it is hidden, so it actually should count as a secret. But either way, there's you some armor. Now, back at the field drone, which you can see it right there, the data pad is right here. There we go. Let's move on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Move on. There we go. All right. Next up is a three-peat and then a not-so-secret secret. Now, this is right after you've beaten the, right after you've cleared the bridge, the broken bridge. You want to hop down here to grab the elite guard. And then pop back up. Do a little bit more platforming, obviously. Don't make a mistake like I did and jump right to where your head hits the platform itself that you need to grab. Now, this is me not remembering which way the door is. So go in here, open up, and look straight to your right for... Or no, no, your left. Excuse me, for a data pad. And then... Up here, there we go. And then a not so secret secret. The super shotgun is back to being yours again. Dr. Olivia Pierce. We are the only now, again, I do have to say that it does have blood. Now, here's your auto map as well.
It powers this facility and is broadcast through all.
Now, like I said, the super shotgun, just for those two levels, actually has blood on it until the very end. Whew, am I going somewhere else now? Wait a minute. Oh yeah, this is me checking out how big the map is. Okay, next up, we have another triple again. So, right here, just a little bit past where you need to go. Now, this one is easily missable if you do not look at the map often. But all you gotta do is just jump on this platform and instead of going right, go left. There you go. There's your creator token. Now, continuing on, this is one, I think Jeremy actually said it, that is hard to miss. And then, of course, this right here, to recharge your health, I needed it. Now, that's the way to continue on, but I'm going the way of the collectible. So, follow my lead, jump up to here and here, Now, make sure and let those things pass, otherwise they could kill you or damage you, which you do not need. No, you don't need to jump onto any of them, except for that first one, and then just climb through here, fall down onto this platform, and grab Orange Guy. There it is. So well, you guys can see the name as well as me. Okay, next up is the next collectible right off the bat, two in row. Huh, I don't think I'm gonna do this again. Well, I might. But yeah, anyways, this is a little bit up the tower. Now what you wanna do is, there's the collectible down there, by the way. Go up to here. Jump up. Now there's actually three ways of doing this. You can double jump to it via the side there, but yeah, you come over here and claim purple guy, or you can do it the way I did it, or you can just go up to the top there and then just fall down, double jump onto it. Now next one, I actually missed this one, so I had to go back for it, but I actually went for the Argent Energy Cell, which is next, actually. So, yeah. Anyways, you want to be up here where the invincibility, or invulnerability, I think it is. I can't remember whether it's invincible or invulnerable. It's the green one. It's the green power-up. But, yeah. Anyways, come over here, hop on this guy. Now, as you can see right there, that's where you need to go. But, you gotta ride this guy all the way up. Go. There's a lever for you. Alright, once you pull the lever, you gotta wait for this guy to pop back out. There he goes. Now, don't make the mistake of falling off, because from this height, from certain heights, your high jump boots will not boost you back up. It will actually fail to activate and pretty much kill you upon landing. Now, the basics of this is you can either wait for this guy to come out, like I'm doing here, or you can actually jump off at a certain point and race him in, grab the secret, and then wait for him to pull himself back out in order to do it. But, either way, pop in here, and you get the Halls of the Damned. Wait for it. Wait for it. And boop. Okay. Now you can come out and quickly jump back on top to ride it back up. Next up is the way we need to go through this door. Now I think there are enemies in here. I'm not entirely sure. But yeah. Here's an Argent Energy Cell right there. And yeah, there we go. Come on, go through it. There we go. Got it. All right, let me put on what I need to put on real quick. Ooh, more armor. Nice. Did I? No, I didn't choose the map. Okay. So, now that I'm actually on the map, we are going for a rune. The next rune in the puzzle piece. Or the rune circle. I don't know what it's actually called. But, yeah, anyways. From this point here. Now, this is not where you got the energy cell from. This is actually further up on the tower. Now, there will be a Hell Knight spawn there. And a bunch of enemies spawning here. But what you want to do is you want to come all the way over to here, wait for this little cart to pass by, and there we go. And there's the room right over there. Let me go take care of it. There we go. Okay. Next up is another data pad. No, I'm looking at the wrong one. Actually, it is an elite guard. So pop over to here, pop this. Now, you can actually go down there to grab a mega health. Just a little bit of a secret, I already got it. Now, I forgot where it was until there. It's actually behind me. So, right there, behind the pillar. And you get your elite guard. Alright, next up from the elite guard, you're going to go all the way to where you need to go as far as the elevators go. So, you're going to pop over to here, take care of anybody in here, which there's actually going to be nobody, and then come over here. Now, you can either choose to do this, which is blowing these guys out, or you can just jump down. Now, what you want to do is you want to hug the wall so that way impact compensation can actually do this. Press the button here, and you get those doors open so you can actually go back down. And at the same time, Gauss Cannon a level early. Alright, thanks for joining me in hell now. Here we are at the pretty much the beginning of the level. We've got one secret to go for. And that's pretty much it as far as this little spot here. So I don't know why I'm panning around. But here at the stairs. Now, this is just about where you would get the Gauss Cannon normally, right there. So that's where we need to go, is that right there. Now, this is only if you need the armor, obviously, but if not, then, well, at least come up here for the secret, or whenever you need the armor. There's always backtracking. Now, look, I didn't need it, so let's snipe these guys real quick. Next up, as you can see where I'm at, there we go. Now, this is the yellow skull key, and we are going for an elite guard, so just follow my path, because it's just barely at the yellow key, the yellow skull door. Just barely after, I should say. So let's let it open. There we go. Our first elite guard in hell. Now, at the same time, here is an artifact. Now, I'm going to give it a listen, but if you want to skip it, go for it.
In the first battle, when the shadows first lengthened, one stood, burned by the embers of Armageddon, his soul blistered by the fires of hell, and tainted beyond ascension. He chose the path of perpetual torment. In his ravenous hatred, he found no peace, and with boiling blood, he scoured the umbral plains, seeking vengeance against the Dark Lords who had wronged him. He wore the crown of the Night Sentinels, and those that tasted the bite of his sword named him the Doom Slayer.
Alright, thanks for joining me back here. Now, the next part is a collectible. Now, the only reason I had that, by the way, playing was mostly because I'm going to put all of the artifacts, all 7 of them, into one video. Now, like I said, next up is a collectible. So, what we're going to do is, this is going along the storyline. Alright, now right over there was the secret armor, so go ahead and go grab that if you want to, otherwise traverse the platforms. Once you get up here, press the red skull switch, and that'll open that door. Now, I actually remember my main playthrough, I was trying to destroy that. Now, once you go through here, there will be revenants, or not revenants, unwilling, I think it is. Unwilling, unforgiving, I forget what they're called. But anyways, take care of these five. Now, this is a good spot for the chain gun. Weapon mastery, just reload the level over and over again. But pop through here and grab Astro Guy. Okay, and next up is a new rune. Right over here, close to the blue door. What you want to do is you want to fight this battle out. That's in this area. Then come over to here, jump up top here and here. Do a little bit of platforming, obviously. Then come over here and grab the rune. Now, this is actually a rune that I missed in my initial playthrough. So, I went ahead and grabbed it. I might go ahead and play it now, so see you in a second. Okay, now that that one's taken care of, we've got another triple threat here. Bet anything you guys can see exactly where I'm going with this. Okay, this is at the blue skull door, so right afterwards, we've got an Argent energy cell. Now let me go ahead and power this on. Use it. Do it. Grab some ammo. There we go. Now I only grabbed ammo because I was actually kind of... Ooh, there we go. Because I was actually kind of running low. Now this next one, you can either kill the enemies real quick or jump down here and yeah, definitely kill the helmet. Boop, there we go. Boop. And go through here for the chain gun. A level early. Alright, and then once that's done, come over here, take care of this guy. While another one spawns in on top of him. Kill him as well. Alright, then pop up here. Get a little bit of platforming to get back. And then instead of going through the door, just head to the right. Take care of the lost souls and the revenant. And then just follow my path. Now there will be more lost souls over here. You can either bypass them or you can go up here to this I don't remember what they're called either. Hellraiser, that's it. And then follow my path this way for elite guard. Now normally you would go straight and miss this guy altogether, but if you go right, there he is. Now, next up is the auto map. Now, this is a big battle right here, and this door, that was just me grabbing health, will open. This door will open during the battle, letting out a mancubus. So be careful of that as you grab the auto map. And there's the door right there. Like I said, it will come up and shove a mancubus down your throat. So definitely be careful. Alright, now from the auto map, we've got another triple threat. There's the auto map there. So you want to go through like you're going through the rest of the part. And like I said, this will be skippable, so skip it if you need to.
Tempered by the fires of hell, his iron will remains steadfast through the passage that preys upon the weak. For he alone was the Hellwalker, the unchained predator who sought retribution in all quarters, dark and light, fire and ice, in the beginning and the end, and he hunted the slaves of doom with barbarous cruelty, for he passed through the divide as none but demon had before.
All right, now that that's done, next up is a data pad. and then an elite guard. Now, the data pad is actually on the way. The elite guard, I think, is hidden, but I'm not entirely sure. So from there... Oh, come on, move around. There we go. I'm going to go here. Now, like I said, data pad's on the way, so you can collect it there. And yes, it's not hidden. You just have to keep going straight instead of turning the way you need to go. And there is your next elite guard. Alright. And then you continue on through there. Now, from the auto map again, we gotta go for another rune. I completely forgot about this, otherwise I would have grabbed it sooner. So anyways, turn around and go straight away from it, through this door over here, to grab the rune. Now that will open up, I think, once you beat the rune. Okay, so, you beaten the rune. Sorry about that little sniffle there. Go back out, because we've got another triple threat here. Now, follow your way up, and then turn around here, double jump to here, and your next collectible, red guy. Now, don't be like me. I tried to get up there through that, so use the stairs. Then come over here for field drone. And data pad. And there you have it, Doom Guy lore. Okay, next up is the lever for the area. Now, what you want to do is come over here, take care of the Hell Barons or Barons of Hell, go into this cave, say hi to Mr. Oh, I took an arrow in the knee from Skyrim. And then come over here and grab this lever. Now, for the map, you can choose to... You can either go off this way or the other way. The other way would be faster, but I chose this way either way. And then, right through here. This will be your classic map, Slough of Despair. Oh yeah, and there you go. Once you hit those two buttons, you got a treasure trove of stuff, along with an Omega Health. An Omega Health? Omega Health. I have no idea what I'm saying. Oh yeah, and there we go. Little secret area as well. So pretty much two secret areas within the secret area. Next up is another triple threat. This area here, you actually have two revenants fighting a mancubus. Kill them, and then jump over to here and take care of the two cacodemons, or cockademons, or whatever they're called, that are coming at you from that way. And come down here for a data pad. Next up is another artifact. Take care of these guys. Take care of the mancubus. Okay. And once that's all taken care of, just come straight up. Now, again, for your weapon masteries, I do have to say that this area as well is also good for the chain gun weapon masteries. Because there's four or five of them that always line up in a row. Now, once you come over to here, you're going to take a listen to the artifact.
And in his conquest against the blackened souls of the doomed, his prowess was shown. In his crusade, the Seraphim bestowed upon him terrible power and speed. And with his might, he crushed the obsidian pillars of the blood temples. He set forth without pity upon
right after that is an elite guard, so just continue on the path. Do a little bit more platforming. And you can either take care of these guys or go straight for it. I chose to actually take care of them. So let me go. Kill them up. Perfect. There we go. Grenade. Boop. Die. Okay, now come over here and grab the elite guard. Alright, as for the last data pad and last entire collectible here, it's close to the end of the level and it's along the way, so it's easily missable, but yet at the same time hard to miss. Just like that one earlier, but it's right here, the data pad. Let me grab it. There we go. Now, go take on the enemy. Crush, kill. Feel free to use the annotations on screen or use the description below to take you to a video to help fulfill your completionist needs.